Hello and welcome to my another recording session about design patterns in Java. So first about me, who am I? I'm Alexander, freelancer out of Germany. Here you have my contact information, what kind of services I do provide, like for example, software development for my clients, creating automating unit tests, doing requirements engineering for my clients and helping people to get hired for permanent positions in Germany. So if you're interested and you wish to work in Germany, so you can contact me via given here on the slide information. And now let's go to the topic itself. So what it is all about? We have here the UML diagram of design pattern. So basically, this is what I want to show you first. Builder pattern is quite primitive one, kind of self-explanatory. I have, like for example, vacation planner, which creates different days. Each day consists of some information about of appointment, different visits, and maybe some events. And let's go to the UML diagram, more general view on the build design pattern. So you have here an abstract build class from which a vacation builder inherits the methods at hotel, at reservation, at space, special event, at tickets, get vacation prior planner, and such and such. And actually, the client calls the abstract builder or the special builder, like vocation builder, and then he gets and then it gets the object which builder creates. And let's look to the code. So for example, here I have created my tests. I'm testing that I can create reservation object, hotel object, tent object, vacation object. Then I test if I can create outdoors vacation builder object, city vacation builder or builder. In this case, and as I show you on my general slide, there are child classes of the vacation builder abstract class. So vacation builder is an abstract class. And here you have different methods which you need to inherit, and you can use it here in the concrete class. And here you have additional methods. I don't think that I am overwriting. Oh, I'm actually implementing the inherited methods. Okay. So city vacation will have methods implementation from the base class. And yeah, it just simply the name is the builder. Builder creates objects, and the same goes to the vacation builder. This is a special builder for vacation, and it's pretty explanatory. The same stuff. It's actually an abstract class. The more concrete class will be outdoor vacation builder. Yeah, that's what I actually wanted to show you first. But it can see the implementation stuff. And now reservation, it's kind of a model. Vacation kind of a model. I'm setting the stuff up. And then the same. So, and the test goes like this. Let me close all. Builder test. So I'm just checking that I can create different kind of class objects. So here is the test. Let me do it on the big screen. First I need to test that I can create vacation object. So vacation object, it expects to get the result from outdoors vacation builder object, and the builder object for vacations here following input. So it, I'm passing here the arguments for creation of different kind of builder objects. I'm adding two person. You see what it happens? Then I call at event, I adding the event and accommodation and the event itself. Then I print my vacation object. Okay, so what about next step? Then I create city vacation builder. City vacation builder adds accommodation Grand Facedian and such and such. I mean the structure, sorry. The vacation builder structure is kind of the same. And then I print my vacation object. So each time, first time I said one values, then the second time I set different values. So I'm using different builders. In the second case, it's even more interesting because here I passing to the city vacation builder city vacation builder object, and then I call my city vacation builder. So I'm using default methods from the vacation builder, which is abstract class. Okay, I think this is kind of strange because let's just look the output. Maybe it will be obvious what's just happening. So let's just put this on the screen. So I don't think okay, the first output is what we see actually to expect. It's a vacation object outdoors vacation builder. So I have my two persons, arrival date, and the name of the people. Then I have my city vacation builder. Okay. Okay, so here you clearly see that I use different vacation builder. So here I'm actually the city vacation builder. It stores the output. It has a reference to the city vacation builder object. Yeah, and this is why we see this output. So let's speak about things to mention about practice use of this design pattern. Why I'm thinking about to use it in production. So basically, you will see builder pattern pretty often in the practice. It's very simple design pattern. And what builder pattern provides, what the headfirst book described, and I should mention that I using the code from this book, headfirst design patterns, and what the book mentioned. So the benefits of the builder design pattern is it encapsulates the way of complexity. It allows objects to be constructed in multi-step and with different procedures orders. It hides the internal representation of the product from the client. And you can swap the implementations for the builder class. So what is the main disadvantages? It can be used for building composite structures and constructing objects itself can be pretty daunting if you need to know some more special domain knowledge. I don't know, like chemistry, agricultural, something that's not clear to you. In my opinion, the builder design pattern is pretty great because you can have such a situation that you have kind of special type class and you always have in your color class the creation of this special type of the class. And when you take this code from your color class, then you have pretty good separation, because now you have this factory which can produce for you the special type of the special type of the object. And thinking about this is pretty clean, because then you can remove this code from your color class and have one liner, like, I don't know, builder, build, and then you call it and you get your object or many objects. And basically this is it. Here is a builder pattern, and this is pretty simple one. You will use it a lot in your project. If you don't use it, you should use it, because it simplify the design of your software project. Because then you always, when you have some create new or some places where you have to, you need to have new object and special type of the object, then you can use it. And this is it. Thank you for watching. The code itself is, as I mentioned always in my videos, is already on the GitHub. You can look it up with tests and the diagrams too. So thank you all, and see you next then. Bye bye.